anybody tell me what they think our letter is today? Autumn?
S.
S. Very good. Very good. So we've already learned how to write the manuscript lowercase s. And it looks like, whoops. Fix it real quick. Looks like this kind of. Okay. So this is the manuscript s, but the cursive s looks quite a bit different. Actually, we've already learned some of the lowercase letters and they look kind of similar, but the lowercase s in cursive is pretty different. You go up, just like that. So there aren't a lot of similarities here. This one, I'll fix my manuscript s for you guys because that's pretty bad. So the manuscript and the cursive. Can anyone tell me what are some similarities between the manuscript and the cursive? It's kind of hard, isn't it? Yes.
Just the little loop at the bottom.
The little loop at the bottom, yes. Anything else? Caitlin?
They both touched that middle one.
Right, so they're both about the same height. But other than that, there's not a lot of similarities, are there? Because there's this, the line that swoops up, but when you write this one, you're going to start at the bottom and go up. And when you write the manuscript, you start at the top and go down. So it's very different, very different. So we're going to work on that. So to show you all how we're going to do it, I'm going to teach you all the action words for how to write it, okay? So we're always going to start at the bottom, right down at the bottom line right there. And you're going to say, swing up, stop. Come down, curve down, around, close, release. Okay? So I'll do it one more time and then we'll do it together. You're going to say swing up, stop, curve down, around, close, release. Okay? All right. So let's do it one more time. I want to hear you all say it with me. Okay? Ready? Go.
Swing up, stop. Curve down, around, close, release.
Pretty simple, right? Not too hard. Let's do it one more time and then we will do some skywriting. So you're going to go swing up,
stop,
curve down, around, close, release. Very good, very good. So we're going to work on our skywriting. So if everyone wants to stand up. And remember, we're going to, when we skywrite, what is something we need to remember when we skywrite? Caitlin?
We use our writing hand.
Your writing hand, very good. And there's something else we've got to remember.
The waistline is the baseline.
Yes, the waistline is the baseline. There's one other thing we need to do. Courtney?
Keep your arms straight.
Keep your arms straight, okay. I guess there's more than one thing. And you put your arm right here, okay? So make sure you're using your writing arm. And you're gonna remember that your waistline is the baseline. So remember, where do we start when we're writing the small or the lowercase cursive s? The baseline. Very good. So we're gonna start at our waist, and you can use one or two fingers. Doesn't really matter. And you're gonna swing up,
stop, curve down, around, close, swing out,
or release. Sorry, I said it the wrong way. Okay, let's do it one more time. So
swing up. Stop, curve down, around, close, release.
Okay, can you all do it for me? I'm going to tell you when to go, and I want to watch and make sure you are doing it good. Make sure you say your words. Ready? Go.
Swing up, stop, curve down, around, close, release.
Very good, very good. Now I'm going to give you all work, so you all can be seated. I'm going to give you all a worksheet.
Here we go. There you are.
Okay, so first is what we're going to do before you start filling out your worksheet is, does everyone see the S at the top of their page? We are going to finger trace that, okay? So I want you to feel it. You can kind of feel it's got some crinkly paper on there so you can feel it. And that's what I want you to do is say the action words while you trace it with your finger, okay? So, ready? Begin.
Swing up, stop, curve down, around, close, release.
Very good. You can do that a couple more times to yourself, just say the words to yourself, and then we're going to try it with your eyes closed. Good. Very good. So can everyone try it with their eyes closed? I don't want you to look at it and see if you can just do it with your finger while you say the words and write the letter correctly with your finger. Very good, very good. Okay, now we are going to do some writing on your paper, so I need everyone to have a pencil out and ready to do that. But before we do that, before you start writing your letters, we need to check and make sure that you are doing everything correctly. So we remember that there are 8 things that we have to check before we write. That way we make sure that we're doing our very best writing. We always want to do our very best. So the first is your posture. You need to be sitting up straight and tall in your desk. Good, very good. Everyone looks great. Make sure your paper is positioned correctly. You may want a little slant on it, just that way your letters are slanted correctly. Your pencil hold, make sure you're not gripping it too tight. You need to hold it comfortably in your hand where it rests the way it needs to, and your hand's not gripped really tight to wear your hand out, okay? Your letter formation, your alignment, your slant, make sure if your paper's slanted the way it should be, that should help you a lot with your slant and your writing. Make sure your letters are spaced correctly, and then also with your neatness, okay? So I want you all to go ahead and start on that first line and write 3 S's. And make sure you're saying the words to yourself, okay? And I'm going to come around and I want you to show me which one you think you like the best, okay? Which one's your favorite? Which one do you like? Yeah, that's good. Which one? Sorry. Right there. Very good. You all did very well with those. Now, on the next line, you'll notice that it has 2 lowercase s's, so we're going to work on connecting it with another letter. Because sometimes when we write a single letter, it'll be a little different because you just swing up, curve down, around, close, and release. But when you do that, then you have to continue on. But with the first, so the line right under your single s's is 2 s's, so you'll just say the exact same words, okay? So you'll just swing up again. Stop, curve down, around, close, release. Okay? So go ahead and work on this. Make sure you're saying your words to yourself. That'll help you write it correctly if you're saying your words. Like about your S?
I like the shape of it.
bit. Okay, so the formation, your letter formation, very good. What do you not like about it? What do you think you probably should work on a little bit?
That little line out.
Right, so
just a little work.
Yeah, very good. Okay, Allie, what do you like about your S?
My slant.
Your slant is very good. It is very neat. And what do you think you should probably work on?
Well, these aren't even where I started and where I didn't.
Right, okay, very good. So that's good. So we can evaluate our own writing. You can go ahead and erase it. That's great. You can take your seats. And let's see, let's have Kimmy and Caitlin, if you guys like to come up. Probably your letter formation, just making sure it's all good, right? All right, and what do you like? It's a good S.
I guess the tail, maybe.
Okay, yes, what do you think you should probably work on?
The formation of that letter.
Okay, very good. So we all have some things we can work on, but we also have some things, you can take your seat. But we all have some good things about our letters too. So the way to get better at it is to keep working on it, okay? So the next thing you're going to do, we're going to go ahead and skip the SE in the set. We're going to go ahead and go down a couple of lines, and I'm going to dictate a sentence. And I want you all to write it, write what I say, okay? All right. Sarah sang a sweet song. Sarah sang a sweet song. It should take you just a minute. When you finish, place your pencil on your desk and look up at me so I know you're done. Because sometimes it can get tiring when you have to write and you think, my hand hurts and I don't want to do this anymore, and you get tired of writing and you decide to be a little lazy and you don't form your letters exactly the way you should, or maybe you don't complete your work, and we can get tired of that. But the Bible says in Colossians 3 verse 23, and whatsoever ye do, do it heartily as to the Lord and not unto men. So ultimately, that's what we should be focused on when we're doing our homework and when we're in class. You know, I want you to make me happy, and it makes me happy when you do your work. But ultimately, it's not about pleasing me, it's about pleasing the Lord. If you're thinking about the Lord and how that He's created you to learn and to grow and to become who He wants you to be, if you don't learn to write, you can't be who He wants you to be. So you want to learn the things that God's given you the opportunity to learn. So it says, and whatsoever you do. So that means anything in any of your classes, in your favorite classes, in your not-so-favorite classes, whatever you do, do it as unto the Lord, okay? So your homework assignment is going to be to complete the worksheet that I gave you, so make sure you do the SE and work on that, and bring it to class tomorrow, and we'll finish evaluating.